Hello everyone, today I am hearing a dynamic personality from IDM Mumbai, Lakshmi Mohan ma'am, and the director of IDM Kharghar. Hello ma'am, how are you?
I'm fine, Harsh. Thank you so much to College Duniya for this opportunity to interact with you and speak about education.
Okay. And thank you so much, ma'am, to be a part of this program. And first question to you is, why do you like to be in an educational sector rather than any other sectors?
Okay, to substantiate my presence in education, I must say there are, you know, four P's that are dominant in my life when I talk about education. The first one is people, and that's the students and the teaching community with whom I really enjoy interacting. In fact, 70% of my happiness is my students. The second P is the very purpose for which I am in education sector. The purpose of doing good, the purpose of creating great citizens for the world. And the third is the passion for teaching. Teaching has always been a passion for me. In fact, as a child, I would always say I would want to be a teacher. I grew into an administrator, no doubt, but then it all began with teaching. And the fourth is the very perspective of teaching. You know, the perspective of bringing in more creativity, bringing in more innovation. And teaching has always been a great way to bring out your own, being to the world. So I think I made it very clear as to why I've been connected with teaching and the education community.
Yes, right. Very nice, ma'am. And next question to you is, being in such a position like a director of IDM Group, can you tell your philosophy behind this leadership?
Harsh, I have always believed in transformational leadership. So when I talk about transformational leadership, there are, again, four I's that I would like to stress upon, which is intellectual stimulation, creating an atmosphere which is very intellectual in terms of bringing in innovative ways of teaching. And this is something that ITM has always believed in. You know, creating the best pedagogy, being very creative and innovative in terms of connecting with the industry and so on. The second is, the inspiration that I can create for my students as well as the teaching community. So I always believe that inspiration and motivation can be the best forms of, creating the best people around you and people who can contribute to the society. The third I that I would want to talk about is the individual considerations. So in transformational leadership, it's always important to also consider every person as unique. And that uniqueness is what will enable us to bring out their strengths. And that's the very purpose of the existence of a leader. And fourthly, yes, influence through your own persona. I always believe that what you preach is what you need to practice. So I would always want to influence people through what I am. And that's again, something in transformational leadership that I believe that I need to do it first before asking others to do.
Very nice, ma'am. I think there is too much to learn from you about leadership. And
Thank you, Harsh.
Welcome, ma'am. And next question to you is, how does the curriculum of IDM University, IDM Kharghar, ensure the best practice of the industry?
See, the curriculum itself is drawn from the industry. When I talk about drawing the curriculum from the industry, we have board of governors and board of advisors who are industry professionals. So a mix of academia and industry knowledge or intellect is what we put into the curriculum. That is one. Secondly, I must say that we believe in experiential learning. We put the students to live projects, to various practical exposures in order to give them that kind of an experiential learning. The third is the 5 months of industry internship that ITM has. This particular internship, where the student works with an industry for almost half a year, you know, for 5 months, is a long period when the students get exposed to industry practices and also to acclimatize himself to the culture of the corporate. The fourth that I want to highlight is how we sensitize the students with values and expose them to an NGO internship. So ITM has 2 weeks of NGO internship. If I have to really, you know, put it in very straight words, last year we had 75,000 hours of social service that our students did for the blind, for the destitute homes, and various other, you know, areas in the social sector. Another thing that I want to again highlight in our curriculum is almost 300 hours, I would say to be precise, 295 hours of corporate transition module, because ultimately you're preparing them to be leaders and you're preparing them to be with the business world. And so we have something called a corporate transition module, where we actually kind of train the students completely to be ready for the industry. So I think all this sums up a very robust curriculum that we have created for the students, a very up-to-date, a curriculum that really blends with the needs of the industry and also today's times. So we have also got into hybrid mode of teaching, where we have something like an online as well as an offline kind of a curriculum. And we have gotten, you know, gadgets that are important for us to also do an online screening during this pandemic.
Oh, very nice, man. Very nice. So, what number you are saying about the awards? 75,000.
Yes, absolutely.
This is really a great number, man. And next question is that any insight into how your university could be more welcoming to students of different races or economic backgrounds?
So, if you look at the very characteristic of ITM, we have students from across the country. And I think that is also one of the reasons corporates prefer ITM as a B school, wherein they can pick up the best candidates. So we have students from, I would say, Kashmir to Kanyakumari. We are also ready to you know, welcome students from outside the country, because India is a great place to study. And ITM, of course, is a wonderful place to for great learning. So, we have brought in a culture which is very inclusive. We have POSH in place, you know, Prevention of Sexual Harassment Act. And we also have the anti-ragging committee. We have everything possible to create a very comfortable atmosphere for the students for the best of learning. So, I think it's all about what kind of a culture, what kind of an atmosphere that you create in your school, which can accommodate all kinds of students in the school. So that's what ITM is all about.
So you mean ITM is exactly believe in a motto of a university in diversity?
Absolutely. Yes, true.
And what do you think your role and responsibilities to the university and the students are?
Okay. I think one is, you know, learning on the ground for every student. I think that's very important. What's the kind of learning that can happen for the student? Because it's important to prepare the students not just for the corporate, but also prepare them with excellent life skills. And that is the motto of ITM. So for us, for me, for my whole team, the responsibility lies in giving the best of learning for the students. The second is the kind of connect that the student needs with the industry. Because for whom are we creating these students? We are creating them for the business world. We are creating them for being the best citizens with the greatest values. So these are again great responsibilities and roles that we play as leaders, where we have to instill these values, and we have to also instill the learning that industry needs today. And there are a lot of challenges that you can come across in life. The pandemic itself was a challenge, right? So to prepare them for any impromptu challenge, to prepare them for the VUCA world is what is again my role or responsibility. And yes, so I think this sums up, what is the role and responsibility that we have at ITM Kharghar. And most importantly, safety and health is a priority today for us. You know, considering that there is so much of risk surrounding us in the form of the COVID-19, which has taken away so many lives, it's important to safeguard every life on campus. So that's again become a big responsibility for all of us at ITM.
Exactly. Nice. And what do you think should be the university's top priority over the next 10 years?
See, if we have to look at 10 years, I think what we need to do is create a school which is ready for transformation. You cannot be following what you have been doing in the last many years. You must be ready for change. So I think that transformation is the wheel that we need to create for our institution and for any institution for that matter. ITM has always been a transforming institution. In fact, we have already readied ourselves with great learning agility. When I say learning agility, we have been able to bring in the latest learnings to campus, like be it analytics, all the latest technological requirements, Python, Hadoop, or any of these, the latest blockchain, crypto, and so on, which are latest learnings. And we have adapted to create that kind of learning in the school. And that's what is also preparing us for the future. Apart from this, the kind of transformation that the faculties need to get into, the new learning pedagogies that they need to adapt to. We have never been used to, using technology like Zoom or video conferencing while we have been teaching. But today, I can see the change that we have brought in within our system. A lot of digital efficiency and effectiveness has come in. And I think this is the way of the future. The digital efficiency and effectiveness is what is going to define the way an institution is going to progress, and the agility to transform is another very important area that every organization will have to give importance to, considering long-term existence in the education space.
Oh, very nice. Like ITM believes to deliver a cutting-edge technology education to their students, right?
Yeah, rightly said.
And what would you like people to know about your university, them and not know?
Yeah, though I think this will be a very, very short time for me to really talk about we do at length. Okay, but let me just put it in very few words. The first and foremost is variety in specialization. I think we are one of those exclusive B schools which offer 10 specializations. And we also offer the latest specializations, which are the requirement for industry. And these are the digital marketing and transformation, fintech, and business analytics. These are three new specializations that we began a couple of years back and which are doing exceedingly well considering that there's a great demand from the corporate. Apart from these, we also have retail management and marketing. We have financial markets, where we have a lab which functions for the retail management as well as financial markets. So there's a lot of practical learning that happens in this area. We have the core marketing management and financial management as specializations. We also have human resource management, supply chain and operations, and of course, international business, where our students go to Europe to study for about almost close to 3 months and get the best of learning from ESCA, which is in Budapest, and EM Normandy, which is in Caen. So we have brought in a very holistic kind of specializations into the campus, where a lot of good and great learning happens, which readies the students for the industry. Secondly, we focus a lot on corporate readiness. So there's also something called an industry ready report, which we create, which enables the students to understand where he stands and what is it that he needs to do in order to develop himself or progress, in the competitive world. I must also highlight about the 5 months of industry internship. Quite a long period for them to really understand the corporate culture. So before getting placed, there is this 5 months which gives them ample learning about corporate culture. And of course, we have a very strong army called Tailwind, which takes care of the corporate transition module. So apart from the various faculty members who are, most of them are PhDs, we also have robust trainers who train the students on corporate transition. And the diverse culture at ITM, where we have students from across the country, is again a very big highlight for us, which creates a beautiful environment, an environment which builds team skills, which builds adaptability and critical thinking, which is happening on the campus because of, students from different states, students from different culture. Last but not the least, I must also mention the kind of transformation that we bring into ITM. We always take care that the students are able to learn what is latest. And that could be any time during the 2 years that we, bring in the form of seminars and workshops. And of course, a long list, but I think to quote a few of them, these would be fine.
Very nice, ma'am. So I think ITM believes to deliver a 360-degree education, not only a course-oriented education, right?
Right.
Next question is, what do you see as the ITM's greatest strength?
For ITM, the greatest strength has been transformation. Transforming to the needs of the society. Be it, as large a problem or complexity as a pandemic, where we really transformed to give the best to our students, which did not affect our admissions, which did not affect the learning of the students, which did not affect the placements of the students. To tell you, we have had around 376 students, companies that came on campus last year. We had all our students placed. I think we had close to 94% that got placed, 6% could not for various reasons. But even with the pandemic, we have been able to do our best for the students. I think that's something that's really worthy of noting about ITM, the kind of transformation that we go through whenever there is a requirement in the environment. Another important point that I would like to highlight about ITM, which makes it very, very special, is the industry academia connect. We have a large, 25,000 alumni data that we have created. So there are so many of them out there in the positions of presidents and MDs and CXOs and CFOs who are always there for us. These are our alums. The strength of alum is huge. We started somewhere in the year 1991, and that's given us great strength. These 30 years have helped us grow in intellect, has helped us grow in alumni strength, and also helped us grow in the kind of corporate connect that is very much essential for us as a B school.
Very nice, ma'am. So ITM is having like a ability to withstand in such a pandemic situation also. Very
true.
Nice. And what do you think? What will be the main challenges for upcoming time? In upcoming time for ITM.
The challenge could again be transformation, but as I mentioned, it has been a challenge that we have always overcome. It has been a challenge where we have never felt drained because we put in our best. So no challenge can remain a challenge for long because it always gets resolved. And I think that's what we as an institution and we as individuals or capable team are have always been ready for. So you never know, the technology today may not be the technology tomorrow. So from an OHP transparency, that OHP machine that we used for teaching, to a projector, to a smart classroom, and to a Google classroom or a Microsoft Team classroom, I think there's so much of transformation that's happening and will happen in the education industry. That could be a challenge. The second challenge is, the expectation of students. So a student who joins a B school thinks that he's already in the corporate. But no, there is a lot of preparation that a student has to go about with. And with the changing scenario, with the needs of the corporate, I think it is important for us to also face this challenge where student feels that he has landed into a job. But actually, there's a lot of learning that has to happen. So all of us as faculties always need to gear up to kind of manage the expectation of the students and tell him, yes, there is a milestone that you need to cross. There is more to go. And that's, of course, a challenge, but it's an enjoyable challenge where we connect with students and tell them how they need to create a growth mindset for themselves.
Yeah, man. So having a challenge is, I think, a good thing because it will give you a chance to improve in the next time. So, and next question to you is, ma'am, any suggestions would you like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Okay, so yes, there are special messages for the aspiring students. One is be safe, happy, and healthy. So live a lifestyle which will enable you to live happy as well as build a good career for yourself. Learning never ends; learning is continuous. So though you may take up a program like PGDM or MBA or any kind of higher education, it's also important for you to understand that you can always learn through a lot of short programs and certifications that can come your way. And today we have so many platforms that can enable that kind of learning. If I have to really sum up my message, I can put in four C's. One is, creativity, which is very important. So keep thinking new, keep innovating, keep, checking yourself as to whether your intellect is on or not. Sometimes social media and, our mobile phones may dull our intellect, but never let that happen. The second is communication. Today, we are so much on social media, we're so much on WhatsApp, we feel communication ends there. But I think it's also important for you to meet people, talk to them, and create that emotive and social connect, which is again very important for you to grow. The third is, being very constructive. So being constructive is understanding how you can progress in life. So create goals. The goals could be short-time goals, could be long-term goals, but keep creating goals for you. It could be everyday goals. And these are goals which will enable you to achieve what you have thought for yourself. So have a diary where you can note down and you can, keep understanding and analyzing what you have done for the day or what you have done for yourself, which helps you to progress. So today corporates are looking at, the critical thinking ability. So a lot of analytical ways are there for you, and you can really develop those analytical ways through various programs that you can take up. Take up some skill development program, take up some, programs that can develop your critical thinking ability and so on. So there are, I think, a lot of avenues for learning. Learning has to be continuous. Keep progressing yourself. And most importantly, create best values for yourself. More than anything, I think it is important to be a good human being and have good habits and, do good for the society. One bad person can create enough evil for the society. So it's also important for all of us to develop our personality, which is best suited for the world and for all the people living around us. Thank you so much.
Very nice, ma'am. I think there are too many things which I have to learn from your side. And I am also a part of youth. And thank you so much, ma'am, for giving such a good advice. And this was the last question from my side. Is there any question from your side, ma'am?
Thank you, Harsh. There is no question from my side. But I would definitely want to thank College Duniya for this wonderful opportunity. I also want to thank you for all the questions that you asked me, which wherein I could really express my thoughts. Also, I think a great work done by College Duniya by creating an awareness of this sort, where you are able to connect with students and talk to them or, convey to them about all the latest forms of education. I think that's the best way to really give the best understanding about education to our students. And you're doing great work. I would also like to tell the students that ITM Business School is indeed a great place to study. And it will be my privilege to welcome any of you who's interested in joining ITM. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing your thoughts on our educational platform. Thank you so much.